by the end of this video, you're going to be able to generate thousands of articles for your blog or website, which will get you consistent traffic and customers. And we know that's how you make money online. So this app is called the AutoBlogger, and it's completely free to install and use. All you pay is API costs. There's going to be timestamps at the bottom of this video. If you already know what this is, feel free to skip ahead to any of the sections that interest you the most. We're going to install it on Bubble, WordPress, and for Shopify. There's a new feature, which is language, and all those errors that you've been getting. If you've been trying this out, if you're having problems with setup, this is the video for you. If you're new to this, we're going to show you how this works. We're going to generate some articles. We're going to do keyword research, and all of that fun stuff is coming up. If you want to start an AI side hustle by building profitable web applications just like this one, I want you to click the link in the description below. So the AutoBlogger is a free Bubble template. The URL to get this is in the video description. You're going to land on this page and click install. If you don't have a Bubble account, you're going to be prompted to create one. For me, it says purchase. Don't worry, it's all completely free. And you're going to add this to a new app. On your Bubble homepage, click create an app. Start from template. You're going to choose the AutoBlogger template and then name your app whatever. Then click get started. In order to use the AutoBlogger, you need to sign up for a free trial. You get 14 days. We're going to generate thousands of articles within that 14 days and then cancel the subscription. So you need to click activate free trial, follow the steps with your credit card, and it'll send you to the next page. When you first land into your brand new app, you're going to go to plugins on the left side, API connector, and we're going to set all of this up. First is OpenAI. Expand this, add application/JSON to content type, and then add your secret key to authorization. So it's going to be empty for you. You're going to go to platform.openai.com. On the left side, you're going to click API keys. You're going to click create new secret key, name it whatever you want, click create secret key, copy this, go back to Bubble, type in bearer space, and then paste in your secret key. Then you can collapse this call. If you also want to generate images with stable diffusion, you're going to go over this Dream Studio API call, click expand, and add our secret key. For that, we're going to go to beta.dreamstudio.ai, and in the top right corner, click your profile. You're going to need to purchase credits. For example, 1,000 credits gives you 5,000 images. That would be 5,000 articles. Then hover over the plus icon, click create API key, confirm, and then copy that new secret key. Back in Bubble, we're going to do the same thing. Bearer, space, paste your secret key. For the shared headers, add application/JSON next to content-type, and then image/PNG for accept. Then you can collapse this call. If you're generating articles for Bubble, that's all you have to do. If you're generating articles for WordPress or Shopify, there's some extra steps. First, WordPress. Click expand. We first need to grab our username and password. In your WordPress dashboard, go to users, add new user, choose a username. I'm going to use poster, write in an email address. I'll just write poster@gmail.com, and then change the role to author. Click add new user. Then go to that new user you created and click edit. And we're going to scroll all the way down and set an application password. Call this whatever you want. I'm going to use poster again. Click add new application password. And now we get 24 digits. So I'm going to copy this, go back into Bubble. For the username, I'm going to use what I wrote, poster. And then for the password, I'm going to paste that in. Now scroll down and click expand to post a blog. We have to change this URL. Change the first part of the URL to your own website. In this example, my website is not Get Fit Talk. Instead, it is Brim Papa. Then I'm going to copy this URL, open up a new tab, and paste it in. If you see a page like this, you need to update your permalink settings. In your dashboard, go to settings and then permalinks. Then choose any of these options other than plain. I'm going to choose post name. and then save changes. Now let's refresh this page. And if it looks something like this, you're ready to go. Make sure the content-type is application/JSON. You may or may not have to scroll down and click reinitialize call for any of the APIs that you change. If so, make sure you ignore all the fields that you get back, then click save. Now I'm going to scroll up and collapse this. If you have a Shopify store, this is the setup. So expand the Shopify call. We need an X Shopify access token. In your Shopify dashboard, go to settings, scroll down to apps and sales channels, click develop apps, allow custom app development, and click that again. Then create an app. I'm going to call it AutoBlogger. Click create app. Go to configuration, admin API integration, search for blog, and then click write and read content. Go up and click save. Then click install app, install, and then reveal token once, copy to clipboard, go back into bubble, and then paste it in. Then make sure content-type is application/JSON. Next, scroll down to create article, expand the call, and we need to change two things in this URL. The first is this beginning portion. Go back into Shopify, and we're gonna take what's under my store in the settings. So I'm gonna copy this, go back into bubble, and then paste it in here. Next, we need to change this section. Go to online store, click blog posts, then create blog post, and then I'll just add test. Click save. Now I can go back and then manage blogs. I'm gonna click the blog that I wanna post the articles to. So I'm gonna click this one. By default, it's news. And in the URL here, we're grabbing this last portion. So I'm gonna take this, copy, and back in bubble, I'm gonna highlight these numbers and then paste it in. Then scroll up and collapse. We have configured all of our APIs. If you're posting articles to Bubble, this is your blog homepage. It looks like this. It houses all of your articles. You can click into an article. It goes to the post page where it shows an image and then your article. At the bottom are more related blog posts. You need to change the logo by double-clicking, adding your own logo. You can also change the color of the button by double-clicking, coming down here, and instead of black, let's make this red. Maybe change this text color by clicking the text, scrolling up, changing this color to something else. Let's make it blue. The point of this step is to really customize your Bubble website. Make it unique, make it your own. To generate articles, hover over the menu at the top and then click AutoBlogger. Then preview. You can delete debug mode equals true from the URL, hit enter again. This removes the debugger at the bottom and makes the page cleaner. So you have three options to generate articles. You can generate for Bubble, you can generate for your WordPress website, or your Shopify website. Then we need to select an API model. You have GPT-4 or GPT 3.5 Turbo. If you want to look at the pricing for your API calls, go to openai.com/pricing. And here we have an output of 3 cents per 1,000 tokens. That's around 750 words. You also have input costs, but that is negligible in this app. So let's say I generated 100,000 words. We're gonna divide that by 750 and then times that by 3 cents. It would cost you $4 with GPT-4 Turbo. If you use GPT 3.5 Turbo, we're gonna divide that by 750 and then times it by 0.002. You get 26 cents per 100,000 words. Way cheaper, but your output quality is not as good. You can also select your image model. We have DALL-E 2, DALL-E 3, and Stable Diffusion XL. We already looked at the price of Stable Diffusion XL. For 10 bucks, you get about 5,000 images. For DALL-E 3, it's 8 cents per image. And for DALL-E 2, it's 2 cents per image. Most of your API costs are gonna come from images. Note, the WordPress API doesn't accept images in their calls. So when you click on WordPress, this drop-down box will be disabled. You can also choose your language for the output. By default, it's English. I also added Spanish and French. If you want to add some more, double-click on the drop-down box and add in a few here. Let's say Swedish, Chinese. You're gonna have to do some testing. I don't know if GPT-4 Turbo can write Chinese. I've tested it with English, Spanish, and French, and it does work. Adding languages is totally up to you. You can also choose your post interval. This is calculated in minutes. So if your post interval was 1, it would create a new article every minute. If your post interval was 60, it would create an article every hour. Do this if you want to spread out your generations. Next, we're going to input our keywords. You can do this one at a time by just writing in it and then pressing enter. So let's say email marketing, I hit enter, and then flycatcher page, hit enter. There it shows me 2 keywords. I can click the X and remove a keyword. Next is internal link URL and internal link text. If you want to add links to your articles, this is where you'll put that. It's completely optional. Let's say I had an Amazon affiliate link. I would paste it in here, and then the text would be something like, check out these winter boots. Then at the end of all of my articles, it would have that affiliate link. So if my keywords were women's boots, winter boots, and winter boots for women, it would create 3 articles about each of those keywords and then put that affiliate link at the bottom. And hopefully someone reads the article, clicks the affiliate link, and then you get a commission. Once there are 2 or more keywords in this input box, this button will highlight black. That means you can click it. So let's test it out here. I'm gonna click generate posts. It's gonna say that my articles are being written by the AI. Please check back later to see the results. Now I can close the page, close the tab, leave my computer, and it will generate all the articles for me. It's been a few minutes and now my articles are ready. Because I generated in Bubble, they will show up here. If I chose WordPress or Shopify, you'd have to go to your blog's dashboard on that platform in order to see it. But because it's in Bubble, it's right here. I can click on one of them, see the image that was generated and all of the text. I can edit any of this text if I want to. Let's say I want to delete this last paragraph. Then I'd scroll down and click Save Changes. And this is the post page for that new article. If you're creating the Bubble website, you may want to launch your app by going to Settings, Domain and Email, and then connecting a custom domain. You'll also want to go to the top and hit Main, Deploy to Live, write a quick description, click Confirm, then go to your AutoBlogger page, and then generate articles for the live website and not the development side. Again, if you're choosing WordPress or Shopify, you don't need to do this step. This is just for anyone that wants to host their blog on Bubble. If you're using this for WordPress or Shopify and you don't want to publish your articles right away, you can change them to draft. So in the WordPress API call, expand, then expand post to blog, then change the status from publish to draft. Same for Shopify, expand, then expand create article, then change published from true to false. Let's say I had a business that sold lawn care equipment. How would I do keyword research to use the AutoBlogger? I would go to my Google Ads dashboard, click Tools, click Planning, and then the Keyword Planner. This is completely free to use. I'd go Discover New Keywords. I'm gonna start with a base keyword, lawn cutting equipment, hit Get Results, click this box, copy the 500 keywords on this first page. I'd go to this free comma delimiter tool, delim.co, and then paste my keywords here, and then click the right arrow. I'd click select, and then right click, copy, open up a new word pad, paste them in, and now I can start copying some of these keywords. Let's say up to here, open up the AutoBlogger, paste them in, and look, we have about 50 keywords to make articles for. I'd change the post interval, let's say every 30 minutes. Space them out nicely, maybe add an internal link URL or internal link text back to my product website so they can make purchases and then generate posts. If you want to learn how this tool was built, how to use Bubble, how to create your own AI applications, create a SaaS, a software as a service with them, charge your customer subscriptions, make some money online, the How to Build a Custom AI App course link is in the description below. If you need support for this free template, I'm able to help all of the students in the course as well, so think about joining. And if you like this video, there's 2 more on the screen right now. I want you to click one of them and watch it. Let's keep this AI train rolling. Peace.